Hi guys, just a short one I think today really, but I just wanted to chat with you guys about something. So this came up in a conversation I was having with Sorin at electronic repair school, and he was talking about various problems with monetization. You know, I've been talking about this, and one of the things he said, and this was in his live stream actually, was that basically there's more money in teaching the electronics than there is in teaching the electronics repair. And he said basically that he considers me to be teaching electronics, which I'm not complaining at all. I mean, I thought I was really teaching people to repair stuff, but you know, we all have different perceptions. But he put a thought in my mind. So what Sorin was saying actually makes me think of things that other people have also said to me, both in person and in comments, that I teach electronics. Hey, they say I'm a good teacher. Guys, I am not qualified in any way whatsoever to teach. I've never been a teacher. I've never studied or taken any training in how to be a teacher. So, you know, I'm just me, is the way I see it. But I love electronics, I love electronics repair. And I'm thinking, yeah, maybe there's something in this. So you guys have been around a long time on the channel, you will know I made a few beginners videos, like, you know, what is electricity and resistors for beginners, capacitors for beginners, and a few similar. And I've also done the All You Need to Know series, which is covered common components but from a point of view of repair. So normally look at the components, see what they do, and then more often than not see how and why they go wrong and how that affects the sort of faults that we see as repair technicians. But I do see some mileage in teaching people electronics from the beginning. So series of videos in which effectively I will teach you, if you don't know electronics, about electronics, not specifically to repair, just to learn electronics. Now, first thing, let me say, this is not going to affect, if I do this, I haven't decided yet, okay, I've not decided, which is why I'm talking to you guys. If I do this, this will not affect the electronics repair, because I'm currently making about 4 videos a week. It's like one every other day, so 3 or 4 videos a week, depending on the days of the week they fall on. So 14, 15, maybe 16 videos in a month on the electronic repair. And I have every intention to continue doing that. But I do know that electronics repair videos take me some time to make, because when I make a repair video, I do not know when I open that box or look at that PCB what the problem is, whether or not I can fix it, how difficult it's going to be to fix, how long it's going to take to do. So those videos do take a long time to produce. And sometimes I end up with a video that isn't very good because there was nothing to learn. On other occasions I've discarded videos because there was just nothing to learn that we haven't already learned. So there is time involved in that. Whereas with something like teaching electronics, which is a sequence of lessons, you kind of know what's going to happen on each one. You know what you want to teach on that one, so you know how it goes. It's more of a flow of videos, and they're quicker for me to make. Anyway, it's quicker, dare I say easier, maybe, for me to make. So I'm thinking this is something I can slot in with the existing schedule. So on a given week, say 4 repair videos, a couple of learning electronics videos, maybe 3 plus 2 sometimes, something like that, but not to have an effect on what I'm doing. Because I know a lot of you guys love what happens on this channel, love what I do, and love the way that you interact. So I don't want to change that, okay? I did think, should I just start another channel? But to be honest, I think the easiest way is to incorporate a series of videos in this channel and give them a title, as I had a bit of paper, something like that, Learn Electronics on LER, and I can create a nice playlist of all these channels, so the people who really want to watch them can easily just go straight to that playlist and they're there in sequence. Yeah, main advantage of that, well, couple. A, this channel is monetized, it actually earns me money, and if I'm doing this full-time I need to make a living. Yeah, And B, YouTube recommend videos on certain topics because generally, as you make videos as a creator, you become, or don't, become known as a respected authority. That's the word. A respected authority on that topic. And the way you become a respected authority on that topic is by producing videos on the topic and getting lots of comments from users, getting a high percentage of likes and getting good interaction. It's the interaction. Even if it's people saying Richie wrong, but we talk about it, yeah. So that's what makes you an authority, which means that when somebody new comes along and types in "Word electronics for beginners" or something like that, "I want to learn electronics," your videos are more likely to be recommended high up. And that's really the thing you need to get on YouTube or anywhere to succeed, really. So it makes a lot of sense to me, if I do this, to incorporate it into the channel. So why am I talking to you guys? Well, as I said, I haven't decided yet. I'm not totally decided. I'm inclined to do it, but I want to know what you guys think. Yeah, do you think, yes, great idea, do it in this channel? If not, by all means, convince me why I should do it, but do it differently, because I always listen to you guys. I'll make my own mind up, but I always definitely listen to you guys, and sometimes I think, you know what, they're right, because you are, yeah? Or just turn around and say, "Rich, just get on with what you're doing, will you? Stop waffling on about other things. Come and fix some stuff, because that's what we want to see." Yeah. And also, I can understand that as well. So, that's it. Just over 7 minutes. Apparently, that's a magic time for a YouTube video, for some reason, to do with advertising. Get into the comments. Let me know. And over the next week or so, I'll come to some sort of decision. No, we'll come to some sort of decision. Yeah. Let me know. Okay, thanks for listening. See you all soon, guys. Ciao for now.